मे पीस बी ऑन ऑल ऑफ यू. माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर माजिद खान, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर लोकनेत्र डॉक्टर जे डी पवार कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी कलवन नासिक. आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस न्यू चैप्टर एंटीबायोटिक. इन दिस वीडियो डेट इज इन लेक्चर 1 वी विल कवर डेफिनेशन ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक, नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक, केमिस्ट्री इंक्लूडिंग स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक. The learning outcome after completion of this video, student able to define antibiotic and beta-lactam penicillin, understand chemistry, stereochemistry and nomenclature of antibiotic. Remember the classification of antibiotic with examples. So now first is about definition. The antibiotic is a type of antimicrobial substance active against bacteria. It is the most important type of antibacterial agent for fighting bacterial infection. And antibiotic medication are widely used in treatment and prevention of such infection. They may either kill or inhibit the growth of bacteria. Sometimes the term antibiotic literally opposing life from the Greek root anti means against and bios means life is broadly used to refer to any substance used against microbes. But in usual medical usage, antibiotics such as penicillin are those produced naturally by one microorganism fighting another. Whereas non-antibiotic antibacterial such as sulfonamide and antiseptic are fully synthetic. However, both classes have the same goal of killing or preventing the growth of microorganism, and both are included in antimicrobial chemotherapy. Antibacterial include antiseptic drugs, antibacterial soap, and chemical disinfectant, whereas antibiotics are important class of antibacterial used more especially in medicine. In 1942, Waxman proposed the definition that antibiotics are the substance produced by microorganism which has the capability of inhibiting the growth even of destroying other microorganism. Later proposal have sought both to expand and to restrict the definition to include any substance produced by living organism that is capable of inhibiting the growth or survival of one or more species of microorganism in low concentration. The advance made by medicinal chemists to modify naturally occurring antibiotic and to prepare synthetic analog necessitate the inclusion of semi-synthetic and synthetic derivative in the definition. So, therefore, a substance is classified as antibiotic if the following conditions are met. That is, first condition, it is the product of metabolism. Second, it is a synthetic product produced as a structural analog of naturally occurring antibiotic. थर्ड इट एंटागोनाइजेस द ग्रोथ और सर्वाइवल ऑफ वन और मोर स्पीसीज ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड लास्ट वन इज इट इज इफेक्टिव इन लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. सो इट इज अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक और यू टेल डेफिनेशन ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक. सो इन शॉर्ट एंटीबायोटिक आर द सब्सटेंस विच हैव द एबिलिटी टू किल द अदर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इन लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. सो इट इज प्रीवियस डेफिनेशन दैट इज इन लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. But after some years, there is a synthetic derivative is prepared from the natural source, and then the synthetic and semi-synthetic word is added in definition. So it is the main point which included in the definition. That is, it is a product of metabolism. It is a synthetic product, may be produced by the naturally occurring antibiotic. It has the ability to stop the growth or antagonize the growth or survival of one of the more species of microorganism, and it is effective in low concentration. So it is about the definition of antibiotic. Now next point is chemistry of penicillin. So here the basic structure of penicillin is given. So if you see here, there is a common structure. So penicillin, that is called as beta lactam antibiotic. Why it is called as beta lactam? Because this four member ring, it is a beta lactam ring. So if we see here, there is a functional group is carbonyl carbon, then this sixth number carbon is called as alpha carbon, then this five member is called as beta carbon. So here on beta carbon, this nitrogen is attached. So lactam means that is called as cyclic amide. So here if we consider functional group as a carbonyl group, which is present on the seventh position here, so on seventh position carbonyl group as a functional group, then sixth carbon is called as alpha carbon, then this five carbon is called as beta carbon, and to this beta carbon nitrogen is attached, therefore it is called as beta lactam antibiotic. So it is a cyclic amide, that is amide in cyclic form, that is CONH or NH2CO. So beta lactam is a cyclic amide, and due to nitrogen is attached to beta carbon, then it is called as beta lactam antibiotic. Then it consists of three rings or three fundamental structural requirement. First one is the fused beta lactam and thiazolidine ring structure. So here beta lactam ring is fused with the five member ring, that is called as thiazolidine. Thiazolidine. That is, it is saturated, therefore thiazolidine ring structure. Then it also consists of free carboxylic acid group, that is on here third position, there is a carboxyl group is present, and one or more substituted amino acid side chain. So here there is a side chain is attached. So it is the main structural features of this beta lactam antibiotic, or in short that is penicillin. So beta lactam and ring is attached to thiazolidine ring, then this thiazolidine ring have the carboxylic function on third position here, and then there is a side chain. So it is the chemistry of this structure. Then regarding stereochemistry, so the penicillin molecule contain three chiral carbon, that is carbon 3, carbon 5 and carbon 6. All naturally occurring and microbiologically active system, that is synthetic and semi-synthetic penicillin, have the same absolute configuration about these three centers. The carbon atom bearing acyl amino group, that is carbon 6, has the L configuration whereas the carbon to which carboxylic group is attached has the D configuration. Thus, the acyl amino side chain and carboxylic group are trans to each other. So, here if we see the it is general structure, numbering is given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, here there is a carboxylic group, this one. So, it is a carboxylic group on third position, and here there is a side chain on sixth position. So, here this having the L configuration on sixth position, the side chain having the L configuration, that is NH2, L means capital L, means NH2 group is on the left side, and it is attached to the solid bond, that is beta orientation, means above the plane. So this side chain which is attached to the sixth carbon is having the L configuration and in beta orientation. On the other hand, carboxylic group which is attached to third position, it is denoted by the dotted line. Therefore, it is in alpha orientation, means below the plane. And this having the capital D configuration, means right hand side. So it is a D configuration. Therefore, the side chain of sixth position and carboxylic group of third position is trans to each other, because here the solid chain, solid bond is given. Here the dotted bond is given. So it is a opposite. Therefore, it is trans to each other. Here, this basic ring is made up of two amino acids, that is cysteine and valine. So, it is a combination of these two amino acids, cysteine. So, as we see here, there is a red dotted line separated. So, this part is cysteine, this part is valine. So, it is the about the configuration of side chain and carboxylic group. Now, this structure also have three chiral center. So this chiral center is carbon 3, carbon 5 and 6. So it is a carbon 3, then it is carbon 5, then it is carbon 6. So it having the chiral center. Now see the structure chemistry of this chiral center. So first we see about the this chiral carbon, about the stereochemistry. So here is given, it is a carbon 6. So if we see here, hydrogen is attached on this, it is a hydrogen. Then nitrogen is attached, so it is a nitrogen. Then below there is a carbonyl group, so it is a carbonyl group. Then on the right side, this carbon is attached to carbon and then sulfur. So, it is carbon and sulfur. So, this carbon atom of sixth position is attached to four different group. That four different group is hydrogen, then nitrogen, then carbonyl group, then carbon, and then which is attached to sulfur. So, if you give the priority here, so here the nitrogen get highest priority. Second one is, that is CH group, get highest priority, second highest priority, then carbonyl group is on third, and fourth is hydrogen, which is lowest priority. So if we see here, there is a clockwise, so here it is a R configuration, because here the lowest hydrogen is on the below the plane, that is denoted by a dotted line, which is as per the rule. So the rule is that the lowest priority group should be below the plane or attached to dotted line. So here the lowest is hydrogen, which is attached through this dotted line. Therefore, if we give the configuration, then it is the R configuration. Nitrogen first, then CH2, and third one is carbonyl group. So it is a clockwise fashion. So therefore, it is R configuration. Then similarly, on the fifth carbon line, means this fifth carbon. So here again, hydrogen attached, that is from dotted line. Then on the right side, sulfur is there. On the left side, carbon and then nitrogen. Then below, that is nitrogen. So here also, sulfur get first priority. Nitrogen gets second priority. Third priority is to carbon and then nitrogen. And fourth priority is hydrogen. So here also hydrogen, that is on fourth position, that is on lowest priority, is below the plane. therefore it is also clockwise fashion 1 2 3, therefore it is also R configuration. So here on third carbon upside there is a carbon and then sulfur. So carbon and sulfur, so here is a carbon and sulfur, then nitrogen left side there is a nitrogen, below there is a carbonyl group and there is a hydrogen. But here here note the point that hydrogen, which is a lowest priority group, is not on the below the plane, not attached to the dotted line. So again priority is given, nitrogen 1, CH2, then carbon group 3. So if we see here 1 2 3 1 2 3, then it is a clockwise R configuration, but the lowest group is not attached to dotted line, therefore we reverse the configuration, that is R converted into S. So here the according to priority R configuration, but rule is that the lowest priority group should be below the plane, but here hydrogen is not attached to dotted line, therefore we reverse the configuration, instead of R there is a S configuration. So overall configuration of this chiral center is this one, 3s 5r, sorry here 6r, here is 6. So 3s 5r 6r, so here make a there is slightly mistake here, print typing mistake. So here is 6R, not 5-5. So 3S5R6R. So it is about the stereochemistry of penicillin. Now next point is about the nomenclature of antibiotic. So generally two numbering system for the fused bicyclic heterocyclic system exist. So first is according to chemical abstract system, that is CAS, C-A-S, CAS. So in case of penicillin, two system is utilized in order to for the nomenclature. First is according to chemical abstract. So here, according to this system, numbering starts from the sulfur, that is sulfur given the number 1, and assigning the nitrogen fourth position as shown here. So here start from 1 2 3. So keep in mind that in case of chemical abstract, sulfur having the first number and nitrogen having the fourth number. So according to this system, this structure is given the name 1-thia, means on first position there is a sulfur, that is called as thia. Then 4-aza means on fourth position nitrogen is there, 4-aza. Bicyclo means two cycle. Heptane means there are 7 carbon. So if we see the numbering 1 2 3 4 5 6, this one and this one is 7. So heptane means 7. On seventh position there is a carbonyl group, that is 7-one. So according to chemical abstract system, this ring, this structure is given the name 1-thia, 4-aza, bicyclo, heptane, 7-one. So here the main point is numbering start from the sulfur and fourth position given to the nitrogen. Then second system, that is according to United States Pharmacopoeia, USP. So here the reverse system is there. In this system, adopted a reverse chemical abstract procedure, that is here the number 1 is given to nitrogen and number 4 given to sulfur. So here there is a reverse numbering system. Here the nitrogen is given 1, sulfur is given 4, and remaining is same. So 1 2 3 4, then 5 6 7. So according to this system, the name is 1-aza, means on one position nitrogen group is, nitrogen is there, 1-aza, fourth position thia, sulfur, bicycloheptane, 7-one. So it is the nomenclature according to the USP, which is opposite to the chemical abstract. Apart from these two system, it is the main system, but apart from these two system, three simplified form of penicillin nomenclature have been adopted for general use. For general use, another three system mainly used. in that first system use the name Paynum for the unsubstituted bicyclic system including amide carbonyl group with one of the foregoing numbering system. So here the word Paynum is used. Paynum means this structure. So it is a Paynum structure. So this Paynum structure having the beta lactam ring, thiazolidine ring and this carbonyl group without carboxylic group, without side chain, without dimethyl group. So this type of structure is called as Paynum. So this Paynum having only carbonyl group, beta lactam ring and thiazolidine ring. So according to this Paynum, this structure is given the name. So here the numbering is given according to chemical abstract, that is sulfur 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So according to Paynum, the name is given 6 acyl amino. So on 6th position, there is side chain acyl amino. 2,2 dimethyl means here there is a 2,2 dimethyl. Paynum means this only structure. Then 3 carboxylic acid. So in Paynum ring, there is a on second 2,2 dimethyl Paynum, 3 carboxylic acid. So here the name is given according to Paynum structure. Then second system here, more frequently used in medicine literature, uses the name penicillanic acid to describe the ring system with the substitution that are generally present, that is 2,2 dimethyl and 3 carboxylic acid. So here, if the Paynum ring contain 2,2 dimethyl group and 3 carboxylic group, then this structure is called as penicillanic acid. Once again I repeat, Paynum structure, if it contain dimethyl group on second position, carboxylic group on third position, then the structure is called as penicillanic acid. So according to this penicillanic acid, this structure is given the name 6-acyl amino penicillanic acid. In short, if without side chain, then the structure is called as penicillanic acid. So therefore, side chain is here on 6th position, therefore it is called as 6-acyl amino penicillanic acid. So the difference between Paynum and penicillanic acid is that penicillanic acid contain dimethyl group on second position and carboxylic group on third position. So it is the second system by using the word penicillanic acid. Now third, here the name penicillin is used for the entire 6 carbonyl amino penicillanic acid portion of the molecule and then distinguishes the compound on the basis of R group of acyl portion of the molecule. So here the word penicillin is used commonly, penicillin, and depending upon the R means on side chain which is present on 6th position, various group is attached. So based on that R, the name is given. For example, here it is a structure of penicillin G. So it is the structure of penicillin G. Here the R equal to benzyl ring. Benzyl means phenyl plus CH2. It is a benzyl group. R equal to benzyl group. So this up to carbonyl group structure is same. Only here the changes in the structure in case of many antibiotic. So here R equal to benzyl group. Therefore penicillin G is also called as benzyl penicillin. So here the word penicillin is used and the group which is equal to R, that is substituent on the side position. So penicillin G, according to this system, benzyl penicillin name is given. Another example, that is penicillin V. So here R equal to phenoxymethyl group. So here R equal to, that is phenoxymethyl penicillin. So penicillin V is also called as phenoxymethyl penicillin. Similarly, methicillin, here R equal to this ring, that is 2,6-dimethoxy phenyl penicillin. So here R equal to 2,6-dimethoxyphenyl, and the word is penicillin. So it is about the nomenclature of penicillin. Then next point, that is classification of antibiotic. So here first class is beta lactam antibiotic. So it is the main first class, beta lactam antibiotic. So as we discuss, beta lactam means these are the drug which contain beta lactam ring. And what do you mean by beta lactam ring? Beta lactam ring is a four membrane ring. It is also called a cyclic amide, where the on beta carbon nitrogen is attached. So fourth carbon ring is called as beta lactam ring. So it is the first class of antibiotic, that is beta lactam antibiotic. So in case of beta lactam antibiotic, there is a two class, penicillin and cephalosporins. So here in case of classification, beta lactam antibiotic further classified into capital A, beta lactam fused to saturated 5-member ring. So this 4-member ring, that is beta lactam ring, attached to the this one is beta lactam ring. Only 4-member ring is called as beta lactam ring. When it is fused to saturated 5-member ring, so 5-member ring but saturated, in that again subdivision small a, beta lactam containing thiazolidine ring are named as penem. So here this beta lactam ring attached to saturated 5-member ring, and this saturated 5-member ring is thiazolidine. So it is called as penem. So in short, penem means beta lactam plus thiazolidine ring. In some cases, this penem ring having the two oxo group on sulfur, that is called as penem 11 dioxide. Here penem 11 dioxide, example is sulbactam. So the example of penem containing antibiotic, penicillin G, penicillin V, methicillin, ampicillin, amoxicillin. It is the example of penicillin which contain penem ring. And the example of penem 11 dioxide is sulbactam. It is the antibiotic sulbactam. So beta lactam is the first major class. In that, capital A, beta lactam fused to saturated 5-member ring. In that, again, small a, beta lactam containing thiazolidine ring is called as penem. Then small b, beta lactam containing pyrolidine ring and then called as carbapenem. So here instead of thiazolidine ring, there is a pyrolidine ring. There is a no sulfur here. So if we remove the sulfur from the penem, then it is called as carbapenem. So in short, this beta lactam fused to pyrolidine ring is called as carbapenem. Example is thinamycin and imipenem. Then small c, beta lactam fused to oxazolidine ring named as oxapenem or clavum. So here again, beta lactam ring fused to oxazolidine ring. So here instead of sulfur, there is a oxygen. So it is called as oxapenem or clavum. Example, clavulanic acid, clavamycin. So small c, beta lactam fused to oxazolidine ring are named as oxapenem or clavum. Then so it is a capital A, beta lactam, in that capital A, that is beta lactam fused to saturated 5-member ring. Now capital B, beta lactam fused to unsaturated 5-member ring. Again in that, there is a small a, beta lactam containing 2,3-dihydrothiazole named as penem. So here there is alkene. In first class there is a saturation, there is a no double bond, but here there is alkene double bond is there in this 5-member ring. So in that first a, small a, beta lactam containing 2,3-dihydrothiazole, therefore called as penem. So here if you see, there is e, P-E-N-E-M-S, penem means alkene. Previous one is penem means alkane. So here there is a double bond, unsaturation is there, therefore it is called as penem. Example is ferropenem. Then small b, beta lactam containing 2-3 dihydropyrrol called as carbapenem. So again here there is a alkene, but here there is a double bond. So in previous case carbapenem, but here is a alkene, that is carbapenem. So it is a small b class. Then small c, beta lactam fused to unsaturated 6-member ring. Now here 5-member ki jagah par 6-member ring, that is beta lactam fused to unsaturated, means double bond and 6-member ring. So beta, isn't that again small a, beta lactam containing 3-6 dihydro 1-3 thiazine ring named as safim. So here there is a 6-member ring which is unsaturated. So here the 6-member ring is 1-3 thiazine ring, and this term is given safim. So again here there is a e, safim, means it is a alkene type. Example is safimycin, cephalexine. Then small b, beta lactam containing 1-2-3-4 tetrahydropyridine ring called as carbasafim. So again here there is a 6-member ring, but here the ring is tetrahydropyridine, so here is a pyridine ring, it is called as carbasafim. Then small c, beta lactam containing 3-6 dihydro 1-3 oxazine named as oxazafim. So here there is a 6-member ring, but with oxygen, and the ring is oxazine, therefore it is called as oxazafim. Example is, that is moxalectum and flumoxave. Moxalectum and flumoxave is an example of this category. Then small d, beta lactam not fused to any other ring. So here only beta lactam ring is present, that is called as monobactam. Mono means one. So here there is only one ring. This beta lactam ring is not attached to any other ring. It is only beta lactam ring. So therefore it is called as monobactam. So it is a monobactam. Example is Aestrionum tegeomonam. So it is the first class, that is beta lactam. So again I repeat, first class is beta lactam antibiotic. In that small a, beta lactam fused to saturated 5-member ring. Then again in that, beta lactam containing thiazolidine ring is named as penem. Then beta lactam containing pyrolidine ring, it is called as carbapenem. Then beta lactam fused to oxazolidine ring, it is called as oxapenem or clavum. Then beta lactam fused to unsaturated 5-member ring, example is penem, then carbapenem, then safim. Then beta lactam fused to 6-member ring, so in that first one is carbasafim, which contain tetrahydropyridine ring. Then oxazafim, which contain oxazine ring. Then beta lactam fused to not any other ring, that is monobactam. So it is the beta lactam classification. Then other antibiotic, that is main second classification, aminoglycoside. Example is streptomycin, neomycin, kanamycin. Then third one is tetracycline. Example, chlortetracycline, oxytetracycline, doxytetracycline. Then fourth, peptide antibiotic. Example, vancomycin, bacitracin. Then macrolide. Example, erythromycin, azithromycin. Then next one is lincomycin, that is clindamycin. And last one is unclassified, that is chloramphenicol, amphotericin, griseofulvene. So it is the total classification of antibiotic. So in exam, if question is asked, classify the antibiotic, then you have to write all type of classification, that is beta lactam classification, then this all aminoglycoside, tetracycline, etc., etc. But if the question is asked, classify the beta-lactam antibiotic for 2 marks, then you have to write only classification of beta-lactam antibiotic, that is penem, safem, all that. So it is about the classification of antibiotic. So if you like the video, then subscribe the channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.